Hey, what's up guys, Indian Sensei here. Welcome back to another episode of Ninja Voltage. So this is the part 2 of the Ninja Tool Guide. So if you haven't already watched the part 1, I recommend watching that first. And in this video, I'm gonna help you decide what tools you can use on attack mission mains, support, defenders, etc. And I'm not gonna discuss what cards to use. I'm just only gonna talk about the tools. I made a video about the card selection a long time ago, which is still valid. You can check that out. So let's get started. Let me start by saying this, that if you have the roundup tools for any shinobi I'm about to mention, definitely use that, then decide the rest of the tools. So first we are gonna look at the top attack mission mains. So currently people are using Edo Itachi, Hokage Naruto, Kankuro, DMS Kakashi, Sixpath Naruto, Indra, Jubito as a main in attack mission. So let's first discuss the blue units. DMS Kakashi. So he basically needs CP tools, that's the end of the story. I mean, even right now he is boosted in attack mission, but he still needs a lot of CP. Because his jutsu take up so much CP and the damage is also not that great. Even with a Rin in your support, it doesn't help that much. So just get as much CP tools as possible on him and as much CP cards as you can put on him. Now Sixpath Naruto on the other hand needs a good amount of attack and defense. Because his jutsu have seal and dot damage, so he don't face any problems with damage. You don't need to use his jutsu as much as DMS Kakashi. So a combination of attack and defense tool works perfectly for him. But make sure you have at least 3300 CP when using him as a main. So adjust the tools and card accordingly. You can go with 3 ring replicas or attack specific tools, it's up to you. Or even with white ring replicas for that extra CP and attack. So coming on to Kankuro. Now what he needs are some jutsu nature tools with high attack and nature power boost. Because one of his attack is shotgun and the other one is seal, so he just need to use these two jutsus. His ultimate has like everything, CP recovery, HP recovery, half cooldown, etc. So you don't face any problems in terms of CP. Just put some nature power tools such as chain and sickle, which gives annihilation boost for his shotgun jutsu. If you don't have the factory ones, you can use the new shuriken or the purple kunai. Now coming on to Indra. So he doesn't face any CP issues because he has a 0 CP jutsu which recovers 100 CP for him. So you have to focus on giving him attack and nature power boost. So that's it. So two of his jutsus are annihilation. It's better if you use annihilation boosting tools like chain sickle, the new shuriken from Tam or purple kunai. So now coming on to Hokage Naruto. He is yellow unit, so he lacks attack power. So as you might know, he is currently one of the best mains in the game, but if you give him a lot of attack, then you are gonna miss out on CP. If you give him a lot of CP, then you are gonna miss out on attack. But the thing is, Hokage Naruto is meant to be used together with support units. So either you can use Rin as a support or give him some CP tools and let your support take care of the rest. Even with low damage output, his jutsus can kill the enemy with the help of his supports. So try and give him as much as CP tools as possible, white ring replica, or even if you have the CP decreasing tool, then use it as well. Now Edo Itachi, so he's like one of the most commonly used attack mission main nowadays. Although he has CP recovery in his Yata mirror, but in a good fortress you won't see the normal shinobis which can be used to recover chakra. And with a lot of CP eating installation in the fortress, he faces a lot of CP issues. Again, Rin is a solution, but what I prefer is boost his attack power so that his shuriken do a lot of damage. So I use these metal rods which give him attack plus release nature power boost, which is the jutsu nature of his shurikens. You can go with the release kunais if you don't have the metal rods, but try to keep at least 3300 CP because you are gonna lose much of that because of all the CP eating installations and short range of trap clear. So put some blue cards on him and get that desired CP. Now coming on to the support units. As I mentioned in my part 1 video, give them the 3 ring replicas. If you don't have that, use other defense tools. So KLM, Gaara, Hashirama, Rin, they all work best with the 3 ring replicas or any other defensive tools with some attack as well as a bonus. Now if you use Ashura, you might wanna give him all CP tools and CP cards because once he starts spamming his heal jutsu, he doesn't stop until the HP gets full. Now there are a lot of supports in top like EMS, Rin, Sasuke, Indra, but I think the mentioned tools will work perfectly for them. So even if they get separated, high defense and resistance can help them survive. If you have 3 ring replicas, then use them. they are the best. Otherwise, the old vest or any type of defensive tools will work. So if you are using Kankuro in support, you can go with the same type of tools as I mentioned in the attack fusion part. Now coming on to the defenders. So there is two category in defense. Some are high damaging defenders like Kabuto, Kankuro, Jubito, and other defenders like Gaara version 2, Six Path, Naruto, Rene Sharingan, Hashirama, Indra, Edo Itachi, AMS, etc. Now for the high damaging defenders, you wanna go with Jutsu nature tools with high attack, because their purpose in defense is to kill the enemy as soon as possible. Even if you give them high defense instead of attack, they are not gonna survive against some top tier supports and main. So it's better if you give them high attack plus Jutsu nature boost. Like in this case, Kabuto has Chain and Sickle tool, which gives him high attack along with the annihilation boost, which increases the damage of his poison puddle. Now for the other category in defense, 3 ring replicas or any other defensive tool like Tails Charm or Vest etc. are the best choice. Now you might wanna change something for someone like Gaara, you know, you can give him seal resistance as I talked about in the part 1 video. But other defenders, it would be best if you give them defensive tools. Now for final room shinobis. Final room mostly consists of shinobis with multiple iframes like KLM, EMS Sasuke, Hokage Naruto, Edo Itachi, Madara etc. So if you have 3 ring replicas, put that on them, or if you don't have the good tools, then you can go with the kunais, vest or any other tools, because final room is just totally dependent on the survivability of your shinobis. If you don't have anything good for your shinobis, then just put the tools from roundup shops, the vest and stuff, anything you can put on final room as long as they survive. Now I cannot cover every single shinobi, but I picked the top ones right now, so I hope this helped. The main thing to keep in mind is that when you lose during an attack mission, then you need to figure out what went wrong. If you face CP issues, then you need more CP. If you lack attack, then you need more attack. It's as simple as that. You need to play some missions first. You cannot have a perfect shinobi, perfect team first right from the start. You have to try them and then figure out what is wrong with them in the attack mission or defense, then change the tools and cards accordingly. I hope both of these videos were helpful. If you haven't watched the first part, visit that and then come back to this video. So that's it for the video guys. If you find this useful, then drop down a like and comment. If you are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. If you want to follow my social medias, links are in description. Stay home, stay safe. I'll see you next time. Sayonara.